Coming to the stage right now, Austin's finest, Mr. Joe Hafke.
John Toll, guys, and everybody else, keep clapping. Come on. Love you, bro. You on my side already. I got heckled by a bum today, you guys. I'm not in a good... I'm tired of... I'm not from Austin. I'm tired of this town. It's too much fucking irony here. I got heckled by a bum. I was driving in my car that I own, like a bum can't. I had my windows down, and he was sitting... This bum was sitting on a bus bench drinking what I can only assume was his own piss out of a used Whataburger cup. He heckled me. This is what he yelled. He goes, "Ha ha ha! Nice beard, ass hat." He had a beard on his face. We're all alive, right? That's good. At least on the outside. Everybody seems like they're scared of dying in apocalypses nowadays. I don't think dying in an apocalypse is the worst way to die. Like, people die all the time. Like, every second somebody's dying. Like, somebody died right now, and then, like, now the apocalypse could happen, and that means, like, if you died, you just missed out on all the cool shit that's gonna go down. You just die doing something stupid, like, laughing at your own farts at the top of a flight of stairs. Like, snorkeling in your friend's pool, and you're just dead. You miss out. Like, you're dead, like just long enough, like you get to the afterlife, like you're there just long enough to like look around and be like, oh, yeah, cool. I like it here. It's all right. And then everybody ever shows up and they're just like, dude, you missed it. You missed it, man. The sun, it fucking turned into like a horse. It was on fire. It just rode around and like burned everybody. Like Black Sabbath played. It was fucking... It was insane, dude. What happened to you? What's up with you? I was like, oh, I farted. I farted. Farted and I fell over. I don't... Should leave me alone about it. That's how they end the Charlie Brown series. He dies right before the apocalypse happens. Misses out on one more thing. Just gets to fucking like pearly gates of judgment. And the guy's like real busy. Real busy. He's too busy to judge Charlie Brown. He's like, Charlie, you're gonna have to hold up, okay? We got a real busy day. I don't know if you heard, but it's the apocalypse, okay? You're the first one to die, so just relax. Hey, Tony! Tony, what's the Wi-Fi password up here? Oh, it's Wi-Fi? Like high five? Oh, that's cool. Tony's funny. Charlie, shut up. Relax, Charlie. Yeah, no, the song. Shut up. It's an absurd world. Welcome back, sir. So absurd world, I don't know. I just got the fucking NRA out there for us. I don't really like to talk about politics because I look like I do. Clearly I should be busy finding potato chips in my beard and not telling people what to think, but I don't know, like they got weird stuff now, like they got Gun Appreciation Day. Like, what are you supposed to pet your gun? Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Secretary Janet, why don't you shut up? I'm busy in here. I told you to hold my calls. You get your day. Mr. Glock has his day, okay? Shut it. I don't know, like, their solution to the problem of guns is more guns. That's not a solution to any problem ever before. And it's like, hey, we're the NRA. We came up with a solution to the problem of guns, and it's more guns. And also, while we were at it, we came up with a cure for diabetes and sweet tarts. So, you just thank us later, we'll be here. I don't know, they want to put armed officers in every school. Like, emphasis on armed officers, too. Not police officers, because that's not what they are. They're security guards. They're security guards. Think back to when you were in school. You remember that kid who, like, you were always worried, like, might show up one day and fucking shoot everybody? Do you know what he's doing now? He's a fucking security guard. You're gonna give him a gun and then underpay him to go back into the exact same place that caused all the emotional trauma in his life. Like, great idea, guys. Solutions. I don't know. Recently they put my favorite show ever on Netflix. I don't know if you guys have heard of it. It's called Mancers. Mancers comes on Spike TV, which is TV for men, which is a weird slogan for a TV station because I thought that's just what TV was anyway. If you haven't heard of Mancers, it's a show. I love it because it's ostensibly it's about giving you answers to questions and making you a smarter person, but the reality of it is it does the exact opposite of both of those things. It's completely fucking stupid, and it answers questions that aren't even real. And it's like, it's narrated by that guy who does monster truck ads. You know what I'm talking about? Like, this is his side job, is narrating Mancers. It's just loud and in your face. He's like, hey! Hey, you! Welcome to Mancers! Hey! Who would win in a sperm race between Barack Obama, Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, and the American flag? That's not a fucking question. Hey, shh! Hey, here's some tips when we do distraction. We're gonna ask a really dumb question. We just bounce some boobs up on the screen. Hey, speaking of boobs, how many boobs would it take to fill up the Great Lake of Michigan? Just the right amount. That's right. Mancers. Hey, here's a question for you. A query. Hey, can you fuck her till her boobs explode? Let's ask a scientist. And they flash like a nerdy Asian guy up on the screen. He's just like, no, no. Shut up, nerd. Get out of here. Hey, Mancers men. Mancers men. Hey, here's a question. How do you tell if her boobs are saggy before you take a blouse off? Trick question. You don't take blouses off. You rip them off. Fucking explosion commercials. If you make it through a full episode of Mancers, you'll have flashbacks to it worse than doing any psychedelic drug you've ever done in your entire life. You'll just be in a grocery store like 6 weeks later, staring at jars of pickles, talking to yourself in his voice, being like, it takes 4,296 pickles to build your own pickle Titanic.
How? Help!
That's gonna do it for me, guys. Thank you very much for this tonight.
Keep it going for Joe Hafke, everybody. Come on, let's go. Here we go, yes. Come on. Big energy up. Yeah.